Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Leak details emerge that those who are having agencies to take Kenyans abroad are now working hand on hand with the government, and it is being described as job fraudster, where they con Kenyans millions of money, yet there's no place, there's nowhere you can take them. So NTV is telling us more details. Let's watch this video.
A million shillings could put a brakes on its dealings. NTV's Duncan Heimber has more on this tale of caution.
The delegation to Germany during President William Ruto's visit mid-September to sign a bilateral labor agreement included scores of recruitment agents who traveled on their account to meet potential employers. Among them was Caesar Wagisheru Kingori, a job recruiter and director of Vintmark Travel Agency, a company already under investigation for jobs fraud. Wagisheru Kingori planned to seek job opportunities for his prospective clients back home by networking with potential employers in Germany. He even posed for photos with top government officials, perhaps to position himself close to power and push through his business interests. But while he was hobnobbing with the leaders at meetings in Germany, he had left a trail of victims of his jobs racket in Kenya, for which investigators had summoned him for questioning, even at the time he was in Europe. Claimed to have lost to Mr. Kingori before through dubious job connections. The Nation has combed through witness statements filed at DCI Nairobi area by those seeking refunds. Complaints include Samuel Kamando, who is claiming 150,000 shillings he paid for job openings in Canada. One Paul Mbatia from Kiambu is also seeking 150,000 shillings in refunds. A Miss Mary Wangare has also lost 150,000 shillings out of 300,000 she was to pay for a job in the United Kingdom, while Matediso Ndlovu, a South African, is claiming 130,000 shillings for a caregiver job in the United Kingdom. Simire Mindinga, a Congolese, seeks 150,000 shillings paid for a job in Canada. But even before the DCI gets to the bottom of his shrewd past, Kingori is at it again, seeking new clients with a promise to secure jobs in Germany. After the Berlin visit, Vintmark Travel Agency posted job openings in the European nation, saying, and I quote, "Let's start your application process today." The Nation has since contacted several authorities, including Labour CS Dr. Alfred Mutua, the National Employment Authority, NEA, and police on why a wheeler dealer who is under investigations is still allowed to carry on. National Employment Authority Director General Edith Okoki says they have already reached out to Kingori. And I quote, "We are aware of the issues raised against Vintmark Travel Agency, and we wrote a letter to them this week so that they respond to complaints raised. We have given them 7 days. If they don't, we will cancel their license," Okori responds. The Nairobi Regional Criminal Investigations Officer Njeru Nthiga told Nation, and I quote, "I plan to have a meeting with CS Mutua and explain to him how deep the fraud is in the recruitment agencies, and tangible interventions need to be effected with speed because the trend is worrying." CS Mutua has also pledged to look into the matter. Vintage Travel Agency Limited is owned by Kingori as a shareholder and a director, according to details seen by NTV. Kingori did not answer calls or respond to the text messages when reached for comment. Duncan Haemba, NTV.
Why are we having jealous when it's come to someone's progress? Assume wewe ni Mkenya, umekuja na njia mzuri kusaidia mtu kwenda kutafuta future. Juu dunia hakuna pali pazuri, hiyo nayo ni ukweli. Lakini the little one he can afford pia inaweza msaidia mbeleni. This guy or any other person have a dream to go and work even in Europe, in the United States of America. Then, wewe uko na nia ya kumuibia pesa. Unafanya kazi na watu wakubwa kwa serikali, mnakula na yeye hiyo do. Huyu jamaa amesweat, ameuza shamba, ameuza hata nyumba maybe. Kama alikuwa anafanya biashara ameuza. Ndio aende nje. Kutafuta hiyo green pasture yenye watu wanasemanga. You mean me, sijawahi believe that there is green pasture. Seek that green pasture to yourself. Iko, green pasture iko, tafutia mwenyewe. Wachana na tamaa. Kama wakati wako bado yako itafika, just work and trust the process. That is the advice I can give them. But anyway, we have a good idea. Having our people, our sons and daughters, to go and work abroad. The government itself is taking advantage of now conning them. We've heard that story. They are being conned. The man is even taking a photo with top government official. Ndio wazoyani nayo. Anaenda anachukua picha hata kama ni Musalia Mudavadi. Kumbe Musalia Mudavadi ni pupe, anakula pesa hapo chini ya maji. Ama anapiga picha hata na Ruto. Ama hata whichever the person. Then wako na deal ya kuibia wa Kenya. So try to calculate. Kama Kenya iko na pesa by the way. Tuseme wameiba hata 10 million. Juu is a lot of money. Kwenda inje si rahisi. Mtu ametoa hata 250. Some even wanatoa hata 1 million. The incident we took place at Uasin Gishu. Today is another drama. Why are these agencies having that interest? It means that they are working hand on hand with some of the top government officials. The EACC are doing their work. The leaders in our country are the one misleading the EACC then. They never learn to speak the truth. They never learn to accept the situation we are. If they have that dream for Kenyans, to help Kenyans, to go and work abroad, why are they conning them? Why are they conning them? Imagine from the executive administration, tunaambiwa hivyo. Hadi anachukua picha na ama Prime Minister, akina Ruto, akina Musalia Mudavadi. Very comfortable. Ati anapatia watu kazi inje. Saa hii anatafutiwa na DCI. Sasa, kama hiyo wakati alikuwa anakula na hao, tuseme wakubwa. Do you think DCI, si wanafanya tu ile maneno ya kawaida tu ya kuchezea akili ya Wakenya. But they know what they are doing. It's very sad. Uzuri, hizi pesa hatu utafute aje utaziacha tu. Wangapi wameacha billions of money? How many people? Hatuko hapa kulalamika. Tuko hapa kusaidia Mkenya. We are here for helping our country na better future. Na mtu akikupea 250,000, it doesn't mean that she is disparate. No, he is having that concern. Maybe aende inje, adapt to the new environment. Again, at least she want to have some skills. Wewe ni wa serikali. Unakula na serikali. Ukisimama kwa podium, unaongea holier than thou. Tuko na kazi inje. Could this be the reason why juzi nilikataa hii mambo ya Alfred Mutua? And I told him face to face, nilimwambia aje in this platform, that this is just wasting of time. Wachana kila mtu ajitafutie. Kama wameshindwa na kazi, waende nyumbani. There are those people who can work. Wanakuja na ile njia ya kusema, watu waende inje. Watu waende inje na wajatengeneza hata creation of job opportunity in their own country. Kwenda inje sijakata. Lakini, pia, ni hali ya kila mtu. Kwenda. Uende ubomoe vile Lebanon wanalia sai, itakuwa aje. Embassy ya Kenya hata wajawahi jitokeza waseme, we are deporting our people, warudi Kenya. Do you know what, are we not aware what is happening? Those are the challenges. Hii Kenya hata wajatengeneza safe bank. Yenye vita ikitokea tuseme 3 million people wanaweza jificha ndani. Ni Sugoi Mandi ameunda yake peke yake kwa State House. Hakuna hata safe bank. Saa hii tuseme Iraq wamerusha bomu hapa. Kila mtu atakufa. Hadi nyama, hadi nguruwe. Tufikirie ile ndoto kubwa. Ndiyo watu watakufa. Lakini tufikirie ile ndoto kubwa. Tusiwe na tamaa ya kila kitu. Ndiyo hiyo imelupuka sasa. Sijui wataanza aje. Sijui watasolve aje. Time will tell. Wewe Mkenya unanitazama hapa. Acha kukua na mbio kwa hii maisha. Live your own pace. Just work smart. Mungu atakusaidia. Jumunga anasaidia yule ambaye anajisaidia. Wachana na mbio. Ndio maana pia unaibiwa pesa. Mimi naongea juu ya experience. Mimi pia nimewahi ibiwa. Not that I'm very much perfect. But they called me 15,000. Heri mimi hiyo ni kidogo. Ana sasa hizi jawai. Anyway, I don't want to proceed at this point because I'm going to talk and expose one or two, three things here. Well, that is it. Ladies and gentlemen, bye-bye. Drop your opinion.